We want to perform indefinite integration, or find the antiderivative of 6 divided by x to the fourth plus 2x minus 5, which means we're looking for a family of functions that have a derivative of this given function. To do this, we'll be applying these two integration formulas. And looking at this first term, we want to rewrite this so we have 6 times x raised to a power. So to review, remember if we move x to the negative fourth up to the numerator, it will change the sign of the exponent. So we're going to rewrite this as the integral of 6x to the negative fourth plus 2x to the first minus 5. So the antiderivative of 6x to the negative fourth will be 6 times x to the power of negative 3 plus 1, that's negative 3, and we'll divide by the new exponent, and then plus the antiderivative of 2x to the first will be 2 times x to the 1 plus 1 or second power divided by 2, and then minus the antiderivative of 5 will just be 5 times x. And then we have plus a constant of integration. Now let's simplify. Notice here we have a common factor of 3. This simplifies to 1, this simplifies to 2. 2 over 2 also simplifies to 1 over 1. So now we have, this would be negative 2x to the negative 3 plus x squared minus 5x plus c. But let's go ahead and write this first term using a positive exponent. If we put this over 1 and move x to the negative 3 down to the denominator, it'll change the sign of the exponent. So we have negative 2 divided by x to the third plus x squared minus 5x plus c. A lot of times we use big F of x for the antiderivative function. So we can say big F of x, our antiderivative is negative 2x to the third plus x squared minus 5x plus c. Remember, what this means is if we find the derivative of big F of x, this will be equal to the original integrand of 6 divided by x to the fourth plus 2x minus 5. So you may want to take a moment and find the derivative of our antiderivative just to make sure that we found it correctly. I hope you found this explanation helpful.